Dear colleagues, I am a PhD student from Klaipėda University, and today, as the title says, I would like you to present some of the traseological studies we had prepared during the last 6 years of in our science institution. In the last presentation, we heard that Vilnius University has experimental archaeology in their program, but we do not have experimental archaeology in our science institution, and we do not have also traseology in our in program in our science institution. But we have a laboratory where we work and made some research. In fact, in past traseological studies in Lithuania were conducted in a very small number. Research was mostly concentrated on Stone Age material studies. More systematic traseological studies in Lithuania, or more particularly in Klaipėda University, which lies in sea coast, in Lithuanian sea coast, are performed only since 2010. But first of all, I would like to briefly present past traseological studies which inspired further Stone Age artifact research. The method which was inspired by Semenov in Lithuanian archaeological studies was applied only at the end of 20th century, when archaeological material from Western Lithuania was analyzed. In Spiginas, four late Mesolithic grave flint blades as the grave goods were found. In St. Petersburg, in Russia, usual analysis of these flint blades were performed. The results showed that these grave goods were used for woodworking. About the same time, late Neolithic settlement of Kubilėliai in southwestern Lithuania was investigated. Abandoned flint tools inventory were studied also in St. Petersburg laboratory. In the last decade of 20th century, eastern Lithuanian Žymens Lake first settlement flint inventory was analyzed traseologically. By this method, hunting and forking flint tools were analyzed. At the beginning of 21st century, traseologically made studies still were not in common. In the first decade, we can single out South Lithuanian Kabeli 2 and 23, Piplei first C, Pamirkinė and Bakšė Mesolithic sites, where microlithic flint inventory were analyzed by the usual analysis. Results from the same St. Petersburg laboratory showed that these tools mostly were used for hunting and fishing. As we can see, all these examples were performed on the basis of Stone Age material. However, at the end of the same decade, study that functionally analyzes flint tools from the metal period and settlements was accomplished. It was determined that various flint flakes from Kernavė and Naudoverė sites culture layers were mostly used for scraping and sawing. This study was accomplished in collaborating with scientists from Torin University. As we can see, all these traseological Stone Age and metal period material studies, which are shown on the map, were performed in foreign science institutions. This material was studied by Natalia Skakun and Gregor Osipovich. Only since year 2010, the necessary technical equipment was gained, traseological and experimental studies began to develop at the University of Klaipėda. In this laboratory, stereoscopic Olympus SZX-16 microscope with attached Olympus DP-1772 camera and Image Pro Express version 6 software are used for the research. Also, the 6 years of research accumulated experimental tools are stored in this laboratory. These tools are used to determine authentic archaeological artifacts' function. I would like to note that scientists working there concentrate their studies mostly on Stone Age research. Only some short studies were prepared studying Bronze Age and Medieval Times artifacts. Me and my colleagues prepared some studies which are unpublished or will be published in the nearest future. So, I would like to present our recent studies, which were made since about 2013. The first studies were published in 2013. On the basis of experimental and traseological methods, some truncated blades with walking traces of cartographer settlement in South Lithuania were studied. Also, late Paleolithic and Mesolithic flint tools from inventory of Aukštumala bog in western Lithuania were analyzed. Speaking about cartographer settlement, it is one of the Stone Age objects which flint tools inventory traseologically are studied the best in Lithuania. At this moment, we are preparing a final traseological study about this settlement. Also, last year, the study about Mesolithic composite tools used in fishing, in spear fishing, were prepared. Experimental and user tests were done on fishes. Traseological research on late Mesolithic, early Neolithic transverse arrowheads were performed also. Functional research was also conducted on the first Lithuanian late Paleolithic Lingvi type 2, which is made from reindeer Rangifer tarandus antler. And in the photo we can see the spots where usebrae analysis were concentrated on. This analysis showed tools function, which is probably associated with woodwalking. Cut marks and tools manufacture traces were detected also. For our prehistoric economics and development research, experimental and traseological methods in animals butchering were used also. For this research, flint and bronze knives, walking efficiency and use wear traces were compared in goat, sheep, bison and fish butchering. The results allowed to raise questions about raw material and tool selection for the various works in the Bronze Age. Nowadays, user analysis is successfully applied to historic times research. In 2014, many artifacts and objects were uncovered during archaeological excavations of Klaipėda Castle. At the traseological laboratory of Klaipėda University, only minor percentage of tools were analyzed. User analysis was applied to leather boots fragments in order to find out what kind of animal's skin they used for the boots production. This method allowed to present some conclusion about footwear in medieval and new times Klaipėda city. And now about the most recent traseological studies. It is associated with amber disc from Daktariškė 5 Neolithic settlement in western Lithuania. During microscopical analysis of the ornaments, pits, you can see ornament and pits and lines ornament, and in those pits we detected tar residues. It was concluded that this tar was used as black pigment to paint the ornament. And Raman spectroscopy showed that this tar was made of tree resin, bee wax and fats. Also, tools for this amber disc manufacture were identified. As we can see on the map, currently we have only some few objects which more or less have been analyzed traseologically. The majority of these objects consist of Stone Age settlements. However, currently we have just a few studies from other archaeological and historical times objects. Considering worldwide practice, usebrae analysis is successfully applied to other periods' research. Therefore, one of the future goals is to perform more research regarding other periods. In Lithuania, we have more excavated sandy type Stone Age settlements. where due to natural processes, archaeological material are oftenly mixed. Osteological material is not preserving in those conditions very good also. Therefore, oftenly we have less data about Paleolithic and Mesolithic economics due to the absence of osteological material. As I can say that we have a lot of flint and other stone artifacts from Stone Age settlements, but we have very few osteological and osseous material. And this problem is well, partially solved by traseological and experimental methods, which gives more data about prehistoric economics in the Eastern Baltic. And about our future research, I would like to express that in the near future, Klaipėda University Experimental Archaeology and Traseological Laboratory is getting ready to publish a wide-scale research about flint and osteological material analysis from Samogitian Highland Stone Age objects. There are a lot of in this circle. There are a lot of Stone Age objects which are dated from about at the very end of late Paleolithic to the late Neolithic, and some graves dated to late Mesolithic and Neolithic were found, and abundant settlements were found. There are some of the osteological material and a lot of flint artifacts were found. This will include settlements also, as I said, and cemeteries. Also, and I think that the most important things, we have two more Ling B type axes found in Lithuania, which are one of the oldest, not only in Eastern Baltic, but also in the whole Europe. And in the near future, we have those tools in priority to make some traseological research, and we want to find out how these tools were made and to find the manufacturer and user traces. And thank you for your attention.